my child. I'd rather go hungry. I got all of Ethiopia inside me, and my blood flows through every man in this godless land that delivered me. I cried so many tears, even the blind could see. This is a woman's world. This is my world. This is a woman's world. For this man and this girl, there ain't a woman in this world, not a woman or a little girl, that can't deliver love in a man's world. I'm born and I'm bred, I'm clean and I'm fed, and for my healing wits, I will call a witch. I'm credited in the fire and been called a liar. Died so many times, I'm only just coming to life. Woman, this is a woman's world. This is my world. Woman, this is a woman's world. For this man's girl. Woman, there ain't a woman in this world. Not a woman or a little girl. Woman, that can't deliver love to a man's world. My blood flows through every man and every child in this godless land that delivered me. I cried so many tears, even the blind can see. Woman, this is a woman's world. This is my world. Woman, this is a woman's world. For this man's girl. Woman, not a woman or a little girl, no. Woman, they can't deliver love in a man's world. Woman, oh, this is a woman's world.
Hi, good afternoon. Oh, I've left him up. Just getting it to the right place, people. Just getting to the right place. We're going to discuss him in a minute. I thought it would be useful. I just tried to do something really, really quick before we got on, before I talk to you. By the way, this is what my hair looks like if I don't do my hair. So if you're curious about the more natural look, this is what's going on today. I am wearing a poppy diamante sweatshirt. I'm very annoyed about this. I'll tell you why. Because you can't see the picture, number one. And number two, you can't see the discount. So I've just, because I'm wearing this today, the poppy red sweatshirt, it is 25% off. 20% off. It's £40. So if you want it, you better hurry up and you can get this for £40. Let me just show you. Let me just put this to the side a minute so you can see exactly what it is. If you don't like me, if you don't like me doing this, find me a rich millionaire, billionaire donor. And I won't have to tell you about these amazing things. But look, look at that. Look at that. Oh, did you see? Isn't that? It's just wonderful. So you can either be a woman who loves, or you could, it could double up as a something just for lesbians. So, you know, love women. Anyway, I love it. I think it's perfect. This is like a really bright red, like a Heinz tomatoes, Heinz red, as opposed to like a pinky pillar box red. It's just a proper, look at that red. Anyway, I so like everything that I make that I've now had to retire some of the things from my wardrobes, because I have so many hoodies and sweatshirts because they are just the most incredibly comfortable things ever. That's what I live in. And if you look at the moment, we've got until Sunday, and then we're going to change it. But until Sunday, the tracksuits, the sweatshirt tracksuits, which are thick sweatshirts and really nice fit bottoms. And we've got jade, ivory. I don't think I've got any on here, but I forgot about that. Oh my God. Have you got that? That pink is just to die for. So you can get, oh, it's so nice. Look, I don't want to keep boasting, but who else do you know that's selling, like, not just nice merchandise, but super high quality, amazing merchandise besides my good self? No one. Don't answer those questions, because I will delete your comments if you start quoting anyone that might be any competition. And it's my channel. Free speech and all that, but, you know, there are limits. Anyway, so this is my thing. Our opponents are well-funded. They are everywhere. They are in every nook and cranny of every single place. Way back, I announced a survey. Loads of you filled out that survey. And then we realized that what we could have had is lots of people answering about the same school, so it wouldn't give a very good idea of the breadth of the issue about school toilets. So we've just reissued it with a few finer points. So even if you filled it out before, thank you so much for your time. But if you could go to letwomenspeak.org, and then at the top there's a little thing about the survey for the toilets. I think it's really important because I think we could have two things. Number one, we might not think it's an issue at all. And number two, we might think it's an issue in every single school and people are frightened to send their kids to school. In many ways, I think you should be frightened to send your kids to school. But anyway, I digress. Let's crack on with Eddie Izzard and the lies. Now, I've talked about Eddie Izzard before. I think he was very much in search of his mother. I don't feel quite so much compassion anymore. I don't feel quite so much pity, because I think actually it's beyond a joke. And however he became an AGP, and even if it was the tragic loss of his mother, and at first he was just looking for his mother in every which way he could, including dressing like her, we are now in, this is what happens with a fetish. This is what happens with a compulsion, which fetishes are compulsions. They grow and they grow and they grow and they bubble up so much that they actually control nearly every waking moment in your life. And we will talk about that after we've watched a little bit of Izzard.
Both names, which is fun. So I'm trying to avoid the mistake thing, the problem thing. Oh, have I gone wrong there? That no one can go wrong with me.
So let me just, because I haven't cut it right in the right place. He's just talking about Eddie, Susie pronouns so that nobody can go wrong with him. I don't want to talk about how the man looks, but he looks like a man. He looks like a 60-year-old bloke with really bad lipstick.
Unless they call me Arthur or Sabrina or something, you know, and then that's when it's going wrong. But so that was the thing that I adjusted. But the public name is staying Eddie Izzard.
Why would that be? Strange that you would keep your most well-known name to keep you most well-known. I mean, does kind of make it a little bit hypocritical, but you do you.
At this juncture, Yeah, I thought I'd do that, and I'm trying to take the so some of the problems out of being open and being positive about yourself, and simply, oh, I shouldn't say this, I should say this. And with me, it's kind of
this is what Hayton and Went do. This is the play the reasonable game whilst actually inflicting your demands upon people. So that's what this is. I think it's really important to remember when they're going, you know, I don't mind. And yeah, hey, you know, I'll use the men's. I don't mind, as Went does. Or I only use the women's toilets when actually women have invited me in. That's the only time I will use women's toilets, which is my impression of Hayton. So yeah, that's this reasonable thing. Actually, what they're doing is they are playing a game, and they are setting out these rules in which they know that they can then press through most of your boundaries, and you won't know it, because at the same time they're telling you they're a nice guy.
I am gender fluid. I've always said I'm gender fluid since, and I've been out almost 40 years now, so it's a long time.
It's a long. Can I just say, I don't think he ever said he was gender fluid. I don't think that's a word I ever heard.
Time. I want to ask you about that, because I think, at least in this country, from my perspective, it feels like there is this idea on the right and among conservatives.
No. It's not on the right, and it's not on among conservatives. It's everyone who's not convinced by this cult, or pretends to be convinced by this cult.
That gender fluidity or gender identity is somehow new, somehow threatening, and that this is the province of young and radical, and you and other people have been doing this and have been outspoken and open in your own journey and experience, as you say, for decades.
Yeah. Men have been wearing women's clothes since, I don't know, Nazi times and before.
What have you learned over time? How has it changed for you? Because I think you came out, I think, in the mid-80s, when I know for a fact lots of people, like everyone was wearing eyeliner.
Yeah, you were really passé in the 80s. Nobody even noticed that you were calling yourself a transvestite, because lots of men were wearing makeup who always just knew they were men.
There's a lot of conversation about gender and what it looked like musically, artistically. What was it like coming out then?
It was tough then, and being, I realized that being trans, we didn't even have the word that transgender was obviously a word, but no one was really using it. TV and TS were the letters for transvestite, transsexual.
Yeah, it's funny the way that camera angle is. Let me just show you a bit of a.
But the identity, the language has changed, as it has, and for a number of different communities over the years, they've changed their language as time has moved on. But there were no discussions. It was just like, if you were...
I just want to say about this as well, when people say it's tough, right? So what's he actually saying is tough? That when he wears women's clothes, that would be against kind of social conventions and norms, which... other people did as well, as like a part of a trend and a fashion and a rebellion against their parents and their older generation. But he wore lipstick and was a transvestite, so admitted to having a fetish. And he would do that in public and people wouldn't like it. I mean, how tough is it that you then are really compelled to do the same thing the next day? Like, it's just that thing. I find that I don't buy it. I find that it has to be some sort of compulsion, really sexually driven compulsion, because I think for men like that, I think many compulsions are actually have something either trauma related or sex related. And I think when it comes to dressing as a woman, it's sex related. It's sexual, maybe dysfunction related, but it is a fetish. So he felt the sexual reward of wearing those clothing outweighed however he was treated in the street. So So I'm just finding that element of that. What is tough? Like, if it was really tough, surely you wouldn't do it. But then your compulsion tells you you must.
Trans, you were a non-person, you were a toxic person. So even though there's a lot of discussions around the heated discussions, it's in a better place, even though they're really heated, than it was before, because there were no discussions before. So now more and more trans people have said, actually, that is me. Because as you'll know, as anyone knows, it's got to.
I just want to say as well, he uses a lot of words and doesn't say very much. Graham Park Girl, thank you for this correction. To be fair, he did get beaten up by a gang of blokes for wearing a dress in public and it went to court. Well, clearly, I don't condone any violence whatsoever. Unlike Peter Tatchell, I don't find it impossible to condone. I don't condone it. I fully condemn anybody that felt that because they felt uncomfortable or offended or whatever, that violence is an answer. So I just want to put that there. However, I will also say that he totally denies the impact that he has on other women, on women, when he goes into our spaces, particularly those 13-year-old girls, when he came out of the women's toilets. It doesn't excuse anything. It's not a what about. It's not any of those things. What happened to him is horrendous. Nobody should get beaten up, no matter what they're wearing or how they're speaking.
A sensible mind. There are any LGBTQ people, there have been many LGBTQ plus people over not only centuries, over millennia, who have not come out because they've...
Yeah, do you remember? There's a really famous cave painting where there's a man, you know, with a penis, and there's a woman with a dress, and it's got two big tick marks next to it. And then there's a drawing of a cave painting with a dress on and a penis. And then there's sort of a picture of loads of violent dinosaurs coming to that person with a penis and a dress on, because it's been going on for a millennia, so long, even before language.
They knew, they felt, or they knew that the society they were in were just going to frown upon it, be very aggressive against it. And they would be treated as a non-person or a top.
Yeah, yeah. There were definitely some people in some instances, in some places, that said some things about some stuff. And, you know, it was really bad for them, because sometimes some things might have happened or some things might not have happened, and they might have felt some other things with some other people and some things in some places and some time.
Toxic person, and something. So I will just lie about this. And in this world of Trump lies, the right wing lies, they just found they could lie and lie and lie and lie and get a long way on that one. But Trump, particularly, and Boris Johnson in our country, just make stuff up. This is actually true. And so there you go. There's a crazy thing. Actually coming out and being honest about your situation must be very scary to the right wing, because they say, no, surely lies. I mean,
I'm not going to say now that I think the right are full of virtue and honesty, because that would be a lie. But this idea that the right are just full of lies and no one else is, or even that Trump lies more than other politicians in America or this country, all around the world. I mean, we are literally watching a propaganda in Iran where the government, which is a theocratic autocracy, that government has lied to the people so effectively that they are literally able to execute people for standing up to the rights of women. It's so bizarre that there's this thing that people do about Boris and Trump. I don't even think they're the biggest liars. I just don't think it. I think it's a really easy way to divide people on these lines. It's simply not true. It's not true that people on the left feel that they probably can't talk. Actually, Mr. Izzard, I think you'll find that we are now in a moment where the left has gone too far, and the left is preventing people on its own side from being able to speak. Now, is the right doing that on other issues? Potentially, I don't know. I'm not that invested in any political side, which is why I'm making my own side. But I'm just not buying this. I'm just not buying this at all. This is a really convenient way to say anybody that opposes me is right, is on the right, practically far right. You know, like Trump is far right, therefore anyone on the right is far right, because nothing aside, sort of beyond the center, is anything other than plain evil. Therefore, if I say that those people who stand against me, getting my cock out in a women's space, all those people that stand against me are right-wing bigots, practically members of the KKK, then I can still carry on exercising my little fetish everywhere I go, including in women's toilets.
You know, Rupert Murdoch and Fox News, they said that we were happy to lie about the thing so we could get people, you know, our base people watching Fox News would still pay us the money because we would be lying that we knew the machine.
I mean, I know he likes Biden, but I think doing this very long form impression of him saying nonsense, saying absolutely nothing with many, many words is, I mean, it's a bit much.
Things were working, and then they had to pay him, was it $500 million fine for the lying, and then just, they didn't apologize, they just carried on. They're happy.
That would be media in general, mainstream legacy media in general. Maybe not even our right-wing press, actually. I think I trust them more than I trust others, but they're all American media. I mean, who's really talking about this on the left at all? Talk about lies. You've got people continuously on CNN and MSNBC and NBC basically talking in the United States of America how this poor minority can't actually masturbate in women's toilets. And what an absolute sham and terrible thing it is for those poor men and their erections.
Happy to lie. And we're kind of happy to tell the truth. I think that's the difference, the two sides.
So a man here who is living his best life, a man here who is telling you that he is actually feels like a woman, is a woman, should be called a woman, has a penis, wants to use women's changing rooms, is telling us that his opposition, the thing about them is that they lie.
I was gonna say, I think also the fact that what's threatening to certain people on the right is the idea that there can be more than one truth, or that truth can evolve. Your truth has evolved. Your identity, your place in the world, the way that you've identified. I mean, I know you've said that sometimes you lean more into the masculine, and at other times you've leaned more into the feminine. That who you are.
If he can be the feminine whilst making some people uncomfortable, then he will do it every single time. But actually, if it serves his purpose to act a bit more manly, then he'll do that. I mean, isn't that what we all do?
Are truthfully can be fluid.
Yeah, I've expressed it. I wouldn't say that the truth has moved. It's just that I try to articulate it more clearly for myself. And it seems that the truth is that everyone's somewhere on the spectrum. I mean, you know, if you're dealing with the right wing, you're dealing with out and out made up stuff. You know, if you go through what Trump said, this is lie after lie after lie, pile of lies, huge pile of lies. And we're just trying to express the truth as...
We're just trying to say that women do have penises, unlike those lies that Trump says. We're trying to tell the truth that it is okay to chop a young woman's tits off just because she wants to play with Action Man when she's seven. You know, that it's just the truth. It's the truth that women can have penises and it's perfectly fine. And anybody that opposes that is a bigot. Like, those sorts of truths. He's not trying to tell the lies like the other side with their lies. He's sticking with the truth, the whole truth, like jam, the truth.
As openly and as clearly as possible. But, you know, I instead of leaning one way, I'd say more that sometimes I feel what I wanted to express one side more than the other side, or it doesn't.
It's so difficult trying to say something coherent whilst talking absolute nonsense is really tricky.
It doesn't matter. We're going to get to a place where it's really not going to matter, you know, because Because people, if they come from another planet, they'd say, well, you're just humans, aren't you? You said, no, some of us are straight, some of us are gay. Some...
No, what we say is, if actually we want to carry on the human race, we need like a man and a woman, vaginas and penises. And most people in the world are heterosexual. And some people are lesbians, lesbians. Some of those can have dicks, you know. We wouldn't be able to explain it at all to anyone. Jam and nonsense and stuff and cake and death.
These are men, these are women. But we know that in the fetus, everyone's a girl in the fetus, and then some get coded men, some get...
Sorry, just one moment. Where are we? Just one moment. I mean, I'm delayed, but... What did he say? Sorry, what did he say? That everyone's a girl fetus. Is that what he just said? Did he say that? Who does he think he is? Jonathan Willoughby?
As clearly as possible. But, you know, I instead of leaning one way, I'd say more that sometimes I feel like I want to express one side, one on the other side. It doesn't matter. We're going to get to a place where it's really not going
to
matter, you know,
because
people, if they come from another planet, they'd say, well, you're just humans, aren't you? You said, no, some of us are straight, some of us are gay, some of us are this. I mean, these are men, these are women. But we know that in the fetus, everyone's a girl in the fetus, and then some.
Oh, I had to do that twice because it was annoying me that I couldn't do it.
Some get coded men, some get coded women, or boys or girls, and
just in case you don't know this, let me tell you this. Just in case you don't know this, when there is conception, men, I think, carry the DNA code as to whether it's going to be a boy or a girl, right? So they make that decision, and upon fertilization of that egg, that egg knows whether or not it's going to develop into a boy or a girl, right? From that moment, there is no further information down the line where something becomes male or female. It doesn't start neutral, doesn't start female, doesn't start male. Starts as like a single cell that's already got all the genetic code to build whatever it is that comes out of somebody's vagina.
There's a lot of things in it, XX and XY, already with the chromosomes. It's already mixed. This whole thing that everyone's, as you go further right now.
Like what you can do is I could just keep going, and, you know, there's an egg and an XXY, and it's all coded and female and Trump lies and female and I just want to put my penis into women's spaces and female and Trump and sexual arousal and jam, and, you know, yes.
The politics that crowbar everyone apart, and as we go more towards the more enlightened center and left, we say, well, just live and let live.
Can I just say, I went somewhere today, very nice man, very nice gay man, really nice, and I had no idea whether he knew what I did, but he did, and then he said, you know, I'm you know, live and let live. And I think that's a really easy thing to say, and he was saying it sort of in support, right? So I don't, he wasn't arguing with me or anything. It was very lovely, but I drove home and I was just thinking about, what does live and let live mean? Live and let live means that some people can do that what they want. So let's take live and let live on a big thing. So let's take slave owners. Well, they just, you know, oh, John down the road, he's got some slaves. Yeah. I just think live and let live. If he wants to have some slaves, I just think live and let live. As long as it doesn't hurt me. Live and let live. Oh, that man, he shuts his dog out all day. The dog sort of barks a bit, but, you know, live and let live. This is men invading women's spaces and dressing as mockeries of us and using our language. All of that is not live and let live. I don't get to live and let live if there is a man LARPing as a woman using my spaces.
Live and let live. It's my own personal life.
Don't come into our freaking toilets then, Eddie Izzard. If it's your life, if it's your personal life, don't come into women's toilets. Like, piss off out of our spaces. Because I want to be able to live and let live. I want to think that my 17-year-old daughter, when she goes up to London for the day with her friends, that she can go in a station toilet or any female toilet anywhere in London, and she's not going to come across a 60-year-old bloke in a tiny little miniskirt adjusting his testicles. Is that too much to ask? Is my daughter allowed to live and let live, Mr. Izzard?
But, you know, also the right wing, the culture wars, these are right wing culture wars. They want war. They want people.
This, look, I think this is how many of the left are persuaded. So I think it's very good to listen to this. The right want a culture war. It's not that the left have gone too far and are stopping people talking. It's not the left have gone too far and they march down the streets and call for the death of Israel. It's not that the left have gone too far and they are trying to stop parents having anything to do with what their children are taught at school. No, no, no. It's a right-wing culture war conspiracy. It's not really that people are badly behaved. It's not really that we care about our children. It's simply that we are all nut jobs and we're all basically paid-up members of the far right.
People hating each other. That's what they feed off, because then people get scared and they say, wow, we'll vote right-wing and we will clamp down on everything. And this is the thing that
he doesn't believe it, does he? Do you think he doesn't believe it? It doesn't look like he believes it. But then the man is sitting there dressed as a, pretending he's a gender fluid woman. So maybe he's lost touch with any truth whatsoever.
That the right wing tends to do. There is no war going on. It's just people being, trying to be truthful, trying to be open and honest.
And you are starting this tour in the American South.
Okay, I think I've had enough of him now, but you get my gist. I just wanted to cover that. And I can't remember what I said I was going to go back to. So, and I honestly, I'm just looking at this. How great is that? Like in the flesh, if I do that, in the flesh, you see how the diamantes are darker? Probably looks a bit like this without so much light on it. But that is great, isn't it? So I just, it just strikes me that we really do need to understand how the other side is operating, and that's how they're operating. They keep calling us, the women that know, that we are the bigots and we are basically on the right. And I think that's why this particular campaign is so important and why we have to, us in the middle, us who don't really think anybody speaks for us anymore politically. That's why we have to hold center court. We have to really be the voices. We cannot be distracted by accusations or false teaming. We cannot do that. I mean, I won't work with anyone. I don't like my name affiliated and associated with anyone. And the reason I don't do that is because often people have totally different goals to me. My goal is to restore women's rights and maybe have a few more. But that's my goal. I don't want this language used in school. I don't want this language of the cult used in any of our institutions. I don't want any man to pretend that he's a woman. I don't want to have to go through a medical appointment and explicitly say that I don't want a bloke who pretends to be a woman to be acting as a woman if I needed a chaperone, right? I don't want to go to my doctor's surgery and see some woman, some large-breasted woman with a very, very useless binder and a he, him pronoun badge. I don't want to have to be co-opted into someone's delusion. I want those things to be at home. I want them to be private. I want all of it just to be how it kind of used to be, right? And not everything, I know not everything was perfect, but I do feel that it was probably easier to be a lesbian in this country 15 years ago than it is right now. And that's definitely going backward. There was something that there was an expectation for most of us 10 years ago that you wouldn't see a man in a women's space or toilet, or that your kids were going to school and weren't having this stuff shoved down their throats, or your daughter and sons, and I've heard from both sort of parents with young children whose kids don't go to school all day in the toilet because they've made all their toilets gender neutral. I mean, it's just totally just bonkers. So anyway, thanks for joining me. You have to get one of these today, otherwise the price goes back up. So it's just on offer today because I thought that would be a good thing. And if you don't know, I've got the most impressive product ever coming out really, really soon. And I know you'll all want to have some. And when I announce, I might put them in some sort of offer, but that will be for one day. So do, if you want to know about this, you need to subscribe to either letwomenspeak.store or letwomenspeak.org. A party of women is coming soon. If you'd like to help us start that. And I have, so the initial barrister's fees has been covered now. We've got other legal fees and we've got other setup fees to make sure this goes as good as possible. You need, oh my gosh, you need accountants. You need people in political roles. You need campaign managers. You need, like, in order to do this properly, we're going to need a lot of money. And if you'd like to help with that, it's partyofwomen.org. And you will see a redirect to theotherparty.com or .co.uk. But fear not, it is the Party of Women. It's just we're waiting for everything to get switched over. So £40. We'll be putting a couple of T-shirts on as well. But this is really nice in cream as well. I might get myself a hoodie. Anyway, if you can stand next to people that you might not want to at this speaker's corner at the end of this month, which is on Sunday, and you can make that pilgrimage, then I promise we will win. If you can keep holding people to account, just like Billy Bragg, then I promise we will win. And do you know why else we're going to win? Because I never lose.